Nicole Hembroff. I'm Communications Coordinator for the Southern Alberta Art Gallery.
My name is Paige Rosner. I'm the Gallery Educator here at the Southern Alberta Art Gallery. And welcome to Monika Sosnowska. This exhibition was curated by Ryan Doherty and Jennifer Paparero. And it is quite an interesting experience to behold.
Monika is an internationally acclaimed artist. She was born in Poland, and she's been exhibiting in all sorts of phenomenal places, including the Venice Biennale. She's really big into installation, sculpture type stuff. Monika Sosnowska pulls a lot of really interesting history into her sculpture. So what we've got here is inspired by the Jarmark Europa Stadium, which kind of came about after the fall of communism and was a marketplace that sold everything from like knockoff Nikes to pirated DVDs and CDs. It was also a really important meeting place for people of maybe more marginalized cultural background. So they'd come, they would talk about politics and maybe business, other important things. So it wasn't just kind of a capitalist venue, it was actually like something more than that. But they did Euro 2012, and when that kind of prep started, they tore down the whole stadium and built a new one. And so these sort of torn, broken sculptures are reminiscent of these market vendor stands.
So one thing that's also really interesting to think about as we're looking at these objects is, you know, the idea of viewing them as a part of the stadium, as actual, you know, furnishings or kind of structures within the stadium.
They do kind of have this original feel, although they were never actually like scavenged market vendor stands. You can see pieces on them that are very market vendor stand-like.
Now, something that I find very fascinating is that Monika has managed to take these very conventional, very kind of, you know, normalized structural things, and she's transformed them into objects that are as dynamic and kind of interesting and, I suppose, unique as the participants in this stadium market in the first place.
The objects themselves are, I think, really interesting because they're sort of a little bit broken. I mean, that's part of how they're meant to look, is this idea of these crushed vendor stands and the destruction after the stadium was torn down. But at the same time, they're still strong, kind of solid metal pieces, and they do kind of have this presence of their own, this kind of strength that even though maybe it's been crushed, all the memories are going to continue on, which I think is really interesting. I definitely think this idea of like these pieces being a touchstone of the Jarmark Europa Stadium is something that's really important, and a touchstone of like the people that were there and the political climate, all of that.
Poland has a very interesting history, especially in modern Poland's history. It's spent a great deal of its time under the oppression of another power. And as a result, Polish people have a very strong connection with their traditional past and with their culture as a distinct and unique culture in Eastern Europe. And I think that's one of the interesting things about this exhibition as well. And I can't speak to as to whether or not Monika Sosnowska necessarily feels a strong connection to this traditional culture within, in terms of her art creation. But I think it seems to be a very important kind of concept, at least something that we should think about and address with regard to these pieces. For example, we have this very traditional, strong material that these pieces are made out of, but they seem to be somewhat manipulated, and their integrity seems to be somewhat compromised, or at least the integrity of the material, due to the fact that they are created in these shapes. And so, again, speaking to this traditional cultural kind of connection that Polish people have with their past, I think it's really important to note that these pieces seem to have a significant strength, despite their manipulated and kind of mutilated shapes. There's a softness to them, there's a humor to them, there's an emotion to them. Some of them are ominous, some of them are you know, more playful or I suppose more serious as well. And so it's interesting to kind of think about the emotions that these pieces exude themselves, or maybe your interpretation of the emotions that you feel when you look at them.
They're kind of almost like childlike doodle into sculpture, but at the same time, they've got kind of a sadness about them that I find really interesting. So if you look at the piece right next to me, it's actually kind of got this stair-like quality, and Ryan Dory actually placed it right across from the stairs in our building because he wanted to have that kind of feeling continue on. Or this giant piece at the back that's kind of the anchor piece. I guess it looks especially a lot like stadium seating that's been kind of crushed up to look like a fan almost. That piece is set at the back of the space to kind of pull the viewer through so that when they enter, they're not just kind of like, where do I go? You know, you want to come through, you want to walk around all of the pieces, and they really change as you move around them.
So one of the interesting things that I think about these pieces is that you can take these very kind of traditional ideas of what stadium seating is, and you can kind of see Monika's interpretation of the colorful, culturally dynamic environment within the stadium. And we see this through kind of the playful and, you know, highly manipulated forms that we see in this exhibition.
One of my favorite things about this exhibition is the fact that you can actually see one sculpture through another sculpture. There's just so much space in between each of the sort of bars in the sculpture that you can actually almost use it as a lens. It can be a really nice standalone piece, but it also is interesting to sort of really feel this kind of cloistered idea that, you know, like you would have felt in the stadium, and that's sort of reflected in the viewing, I guess.